I saw the film Withdrawn Arms last night, and I just want to say I was blown away because there were so many things that I did not know. And I think when it comes to my generation, we see the Black Power Fist. We've heard what happened at the Olympics, but we didn't know, the sacrifices that were made and what happened after. And I'm so excited for the film to come out because it really explores the sacrifices. And so my first question to you is, how does it feel to be able to kind of go beyond that moment with this film and introduce this next generation to what would happen after?
It's an interesting road for me because realizing that the masses of those who watched the film was not on Earth's sight when it happened. And of course, aftermath is even more distant. And I myself wonder how they took what they saw, because they did not know the beforehand, during the time, and certainly not after. So it was a inside for me to show the outside. Everyone knows who saw that or who was around at that time. Know the outside in. Know that Tommie Smith was on the victory stand. But very few know what Tommie Smith thought on the victory stand, his insides out. And that's what the Withdrawn Arms are about, for an artistic view of me on the inside. And that there were things that I said, things drawn out that, you know, one just doesn't realize when he's under pressure to do certain things, especially at that young age of 24. So it is a documentary, but it's a documentary of sociology of how things happen at any particular time and how the movement is continuing, the changes of that continuation and so forth. So it will continue because there's other stories much more in depth than the one of called Withdrawn Arms. That was our first.
Definitely, definitely. And just kind of just speaking to that, I'm 24 now, right? And so to be able to see the film, just mind blowing. For you to have been 24 years old, to have been able to make such a huge step, and for you to really kind of stand your ground was just amazing to see. But it makes me want to ask, like, you know, I about this generation, right? So we have, you know, we've seen the NBA, we've seen, you know, other sports, other people that are involved in sports, other athletes that are really speaking out against the racial injustices of the world and what's currently still happening in the world. What are your thoughts on current athletes using their platform to speak on racial injustices?
I think that platform is very wise to use such a platform as athletic endowments. Otherwise, how would they use them? And the things that they're saying about what happened older 50 years ago, which is longer than they have been born. But they have the chapters of memory, and they are viewing it and doing what those people, not just Tommie Smith in this moment, but those people sacrificed during those times. And they have learned the trials and the tribulation of these young athletes at that time who are their age or maybe a few years younger, how they had to deal with systemic racism in those days, which are much more proportionate to danger than what they're doing now because of visuality. Because of, as my mother-in-law say, your telephone, ask your phone. Every time we need to know something, we don't, she just looked at it and said, well, ask your phone, as if she doesn't have one. But I know that it is a tribulation for them. And my pride in what they're doing is telling the story of a system that did not represent them, or did not represent the past, and they're trying to answer questions which they don't understand about people like me going forward. And this is why this story is so interesting. I'd like to know what they think, what they're thinking about the people who died under the knees and under the guns of the systemic racists who believe that equality is not justified.